Now it's time for Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Hi, Chris.
Hello, Paul.
It is early for you.
It is. Yeah, it feels good.
Feels It does.
Sort of. You know, it's a new chapter. This is exciting to me.
Tell me, what do you mean by that? I mean,
we're going to start doing the show a half hour earlier.
Well, if Paul can get his act together.
Well, okay. Yeah. Then maybe we won't be starting a half hour earlier.
Well, I like to pick a song
That
represents the last week, the past week.
Mm-hmm.
And it is by Ludacris, one of your favorite artists.
Yes.
Of all time. And it's called, well, I got to bring it up here, the computer. Here we go. Are you ready? It's called Slap. On Past Week, Next Week.
And so the gimmick here, folks, is I try and figure out why he picked this particular song. And we don't collaborate on this beforehand, so truly I'm going to have to use my own powers of reasoning to try and figure out why Paul would pick a song called Slap.
Right.
Before I get into that, I do want to say I really do like Ludacris. I loved it when he did a collaboration with Blizzard Man.
Yes.
That was so good. So check that out if you haven't.
That was my favorite collaboration he did.
Was it?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a good... Whoa.
Robot voice? Robot voice.
Luda. Yeah. I mean, let's just say it. It was the big slap at the Oscars. It was a slap heard round the world, I'm guessing. That's why you put this in here.
How did you know that?
Well, I was trying to think, has Slaps Barbecue been in the news lately? And not that I've heard of. So if it's not Slaps Barbecue, it's got to be Will Smith.
Or Slappy Wilson, the comedian. Never thought about that.
I didn't even think about Slappy Wilson. So, so let me say this. We're a week removed, right?
Yes.
So that visceral shock when it first happened is over. So my primary feeling about it now is I'm done with it.
You're done with it?
I'm done with it.
Everybody in the world has said their two cents, and this is your opportunity, your time to shine.
I know. Do I really have anything worthwhile to add to what's been said? Okay. So I'll put on my armchair psychologist hat. I think people need to be looking out for Will Smith and his mental health right now. He's been in the spotlight a long time. He knows how many people are looking at him and the attention everything he does draws. So to be led or to react in that moment in that way.
In that place
just makes me feel like maybe there's more going on than just a joke about his wife that I was going to say it upset him, but I saw him laughing about it at first until her face didn't look like she enjoyed it too much. So I think Will Smith was absolutely in the wrong to do that. And I know there's this contingency, well, when is Chris Rock going to apologize to Jada? When you're in that arena, when you've chosen to be out in the spotlight like that, you come to these award shows, you know what happens.
Uh-huh. And a guy who's been doing it for 30 years, 30 plus years, should know this.
Yes.
At least 30 years he's been in the spotlight.
Yeah. Yeah. And you're talking Will Smith still. Yeah. Yeah. So I just, wow.
So I thought it was, my reaction was heartbreaking.
Mm-hmm.
This guy's worked his butt off, he's super talented for this moment, and this is what he...
Yeah.
It's yeah, I think he's got some problems.
I hope he has a good support system around him. I really do.
Do you think he does?
I don't know.
You don't have a good support system if you think he can do that.
Yes, you're right.
And let's just say this, too. How many times in a work environment have you wanted to slap somebody?
Oh, my God. So many times.
Yes.
Yeah.
I went one time down, charging down the aisle of the middle of the Missouri House, just screaming at the speaker. But I wasn't ever going to do physical anything with him.
Yeah. Right. Right.
And
unless he consented.
No, and that could be inappropriate.
Let me say this. I think, okay, here we go again. In the arena you were in, that was the house, correct?
Yes.
those kind of theatrics are part of the arena of the House. The Senate's completely different,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's true.
It's all about the rules and the decorum. So I would contend what you did wouldn't have been appropriate in maybe any other workspace. But in that one,
yeah,
it was in line with the rules of engagement in that arena. Mm-hmm. So what Will Smith did was not in line with the rules of engagement of that arena. I mean...
Well, the other thing, too, I really worry, and me sitting over here in my liberal bubble, I blame Donald Trump. We just have a really bad perception of what men are.
Yes. Yes.
And there's so many people who think that's what a man's supposed to do, is protect a woman. Like, she's perfectly capable of protecting herself.
Mm-hmm.
And a man shows restraint and control and thinks through things. And,
yeah.
And I say this, folks, I haven't always done that, but I've been mature enough where most of the time I have. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And so, and I'm embarrassed by the times I haven't.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's the bad example that I worry about. And it goes into entitlement and dot to dot to dot. It's just a sad situation. But I do want to say one other thing, Chris.
Okay.
We have a fun podcast. We're going to get
of course
into, we're
we
going to
do.
Get into the We're going to get into the pop culture news. We're going to make fun of some people, whatever. We don't really... I think we should be done with... at least the Academy Awards and stuff like that should be done with their roasting of stuff. Enough with the comedian. Just come out and do the presentation. Make a cute little joke. The roasting is just... There's too much roasting mm-hmm. going on in comedy. And I think it's too easy... And it makes me not like stand-up comedy.
Wow.
Where I've done stand-up comedy and hung around some comedians, and then I did some improv comedy and hung out with them. Improv is just so supportive and nice and positive.
Yeah, I've been in the whole stand-up comedy game. You know this.
Yeah.
And
well, you were the Laugh Olympics champion for 1 year.
I mean, I came in first place, but that's not... I am not here to talk about my victory
mm-hmm.
and not over, yours.
Over mine, over me losing. Yeah. Good.
Yes.
Thank you for not bringing that up.
Yeah, that's not the point of this little rant here.
Yeah.
It was cutthroat. There were some nice people, but overall I felt like... It was a lot of sad people that felt
yes.
like if anybody else had a modicum of success,
yeah.
it was a personal affront to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's part of the reason I didn't stick with it. The other, of course, was the lack of talent. But
Oh, and stick-to-itiveness?
Yes, yeah.
Gotcha,
yeah,
gotcha.
Those things factored in as well.
Okay. So that was the slap by Ludacris.
Yeah, that was good. Good talk.
We had to talk about it. We'll move on.
Yeah.
And we'll get into the show. And the show is... Welcome to Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul. And I'm Paul. This
yeah.
is the show where we review the most important things for the past week and get you ready for the next week. Get your one-stop podcast to keep you updated. It's a real week review. Just listen to us and you won't need any other information outlet. That's our guarantee. It's Sunday morning. You can watch us on Facebook Live or listen on KCTK Radio. You can join the program by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation. If you're listening to a rebroadcast of this program on KCTK, you still can participate by giving us a call at 913-735-0060. And that would just be so wonderful if you're able to do that and tell us what you think. Coming up, we have weekly news quiz, pop culture update, incredible special feature, headlines and prediction, and much, much more. But we always start the program with, what's going on? And specifically, we want to know what's going on with Chris Whiting, the winner of the Laugh Olympics.
That's right.
Can't see why. The funny, were you the funniest man in Kansas City?
I was the funniest man in Kansas City in 2001.
Funniest person. This is way before woke, but...
Yeah.
There were like female people.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
maybe some other, I don't know, maybe there were some other non-binary people that were in the contest.
Yeah. At least at that time, everybody presented as binary. But I'm sure there were some folks that, you
yeah.
know, were on the continuum somewhere.
Yeah.
But again, I'm not here to talk about my triumphs.
You won the whole contest,
I
right?
I did. I came in first place.
Yeah, yeah. But you were there's someone right at your heels, right?
There was. Yeah, I could feel him nipping at my backside.
But I, just not
kind of liked it.
The quality of that person just wasn't.
Well, now the quality of the person was fine.
Oh, that's nice to say.
It's the quality of their creation comedy that was abysmal.
Abysmal, yeah. Gotcha.
Yeah. Now gotcha. There were like, I don't know, 30 plus people in this contest, and you and I came in first and second.
We sure did.
And it doesn't matter which one of us got first and which one got second.
I agree with that.
Yes.
It really doesn't matter.
So, yeah, I really had no intention of talking about that. So, interesting day. Today is April 3rd.
It sure is.
And
I know, as we record it, you may be listening
well,
to
that's true.
Time.
Yeah, this is an asynchronous medium. You yeah. can listen to this at any time you choose.
Your choice.
But it marks the birthday of my dad, Ron, who died in 2001.
Okay.
Ironically, the same year that I won.
Yeah.
But again, it doesn't matter who won, but I did win the contest. He would have been 78 today.
Wow.
And I was thinking this week, I don't want to get too morose here, but both my kids came home for spring break, but they both work. They have internships in Columbia. So I got Abby for 2 days and then she had to go back, and then Molly for the next 2 days and she had to go back. But I'm thinking, like, my dad's been gone 21 years. So he's missed all of this of my kids growing up and stuff. And,
he missed the slap. That's the thing I worry about. You know? As my dad passed away, he missed it.
God.
Part of it is like, okay, good. He missed COVID.
Yeah.
And all that stuff. But then the slap.
Yeah. That sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they never saw an Oscars where somebody got slapped. Although yeah. I bet they did see the streaker behind David Niven, which I didn't get to see. So
yeah, that's true.
You know, potato, potato. But I'm
just so on. This is why he won, folks, because his 1970s references.
I don't know why.
I did like 1990s references, and it wasn't good with the group.
Yeah, people love a good 70s tie back, though. Mm-hmm. Boy. It hasn't been a sad thing, but just a like a realization that, man, it goes by so quick.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's too short not to be doing things that you enjoy with people you enjoy.
Yes.
So that's
or your family.
Well, you kind of have to do stuff
yeah.
with them.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, but the actual people that you like, it's so. I don't know. And I think the other thing that's playing into this, I think we talked about this last week. I got a new job at a place for mom.
I got a new job.
And all week, I've been in training where I'm learning about different levels
when
of senior care. Okay. So I'm learning about what is assisted care, what is respite care, what's independent living, what's memory care. I have never contemplated my own mortality ever in my life as
wow.
learning about the stages that people go through in senior living and senior housing arrangements. So
now I was telling an old friend of mine, actually I like to call him my oldest friend, although he's younger than me. He had a birthday this week.
Oh, okay.
A young man by the name of Bryn Herrick. He was looking yesterday at
a giant among men.
Yes. He's looking at facilities for his mother-in-law.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you need to call Chris Whiting because he does that now.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Stop it, Paul. I got to get going.
He thought it was hilarious.
Yeah, he thought it was hilarious. My hilarious joke.
Yeah.
That you would help anybody.
Yeah. Well, and let me say this, too.
Uh-huh.
So,
also, he said, was he Joan London now?
No, he didn't.
He did say that.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
That means our marketing is working.
I go, yeah. And then he thought I was joking the rest of the time.
And I'm just going to throw this out. It was announced Friday at my new job
mm-hmm.
that they just closed on their biggest month ever.
Really?
When it came to move-ins.
Interesting. So.
So I start.
Before you were there.
Uh-huh.
Buckus. I mean, all they can get is a Good Morning America person from the 70s, and now they've had their biggest time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you believe it?
So, I believe it, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they tried to get Charlie Gibson, and he's like, no thank you.
Right.
So then they had
David
to go with
Hartman.
David Hartman. Oh, damn it. That's good. That's good.
So
maybe they can get the monkey they used to have on the morning show.
Oh God, I forgot about that.
Fred McMuggs.
Was that his name, really?
I think so.
Damn, you're
for okay. All our young people out there, actually anyone, because none of you are alive. The first co-host of the Today Show in the 50s was a monkey named Fred McMuggs or something like that.
I knew it was a monkey, but I didn't know the name.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, now you've out old referenced me.
Uh huh. And but now
the
they
show's
have
not over.
And the same. Now they have George Stephanopoulos. Whatever his name is.
See, that cracks me up too. When he was no longer working for Clinton, that was the big joke. He'll never get a job anywhere. It's going to be George Stephanopoulos. He has every job in the world now. Mm-hmm. He's got This Week with George Stephanopoulos, and he does Good Morning America with George Stephanopoulos.
You know, there's a podcaster, I don't know if you've heard him or not, up and comer, kind of like us, does a show named Howard Stern.
Hmm. Doesn't ring a bell.
He thinks that George should run for president.
Hmm.
He's the smartest guy Howard's ever.
Wow.
It's funny. You should listen to Howard's show sometime. It's like him talking and the news will come up. He'll make a joke about it. It's like, dude, have you been like...
Wow.
Listening to us or something?
I mean, steal formats much? Jeez, yeah. Louise.
Yeah.
All right, I'll have a talk. What's his name? Howard.
Howard Stern. Also, Howard Stern. There's this guy who does stuff over the internet called Bill Gates. Just since not familiar.
Yeah,
since we've been doing stuff over the internet, you know, now he does.
Wait, did he start Rib Tech?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just real quick, too, big shout out. Told them about the podcast, so I know they're going to be listening to Ben and Laurel Parks. Friends we made in Peru, went out to dinner with them last night, had just a great time, lots of fun.
From what I understand, you went on, you met them on a trip to another nation and kind of a spiritual trip to get to know yourself and became close.
Isn't that weird? You travel to Peru, to a whole nother hemisphere, and then you meet and become friends with two people in your hometown.
And that was moving, but also you got fucked up with them last night. So that's you know, that's also good too.
We did have really like raw, powerful spiritual experience in Peru, and then
you got drunk.
Yeah, last together. Night.
So it's a similar thing in many ways.
Yeah, drank more than I intended. Ended the night with absinthe, and I don't recommend that.
Okay,
so there you go.
All right. Well, Chris, I have something big to announce.
Yeah, I want to hear what's happening in your world.
As you know, I look to the higher power for guidance.
Okay.
And that's called astrology.
Yes.
And I use an app that tells me about astrology.
I've heard of this
app. It's called The Pattern.
Mm-hmm.
And The Pattern, I'm allowed to put my friend's astrology in there and then see if we sync.
Yeah.
This is what I got yesterday. Are you ready?
Yes.
Your life is aligned with Chris's. And it's you, Chris.
What?
And this isn't Chris Rock.
Oh.
It's you.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
And this friendship is incredibly powerful in terms of future possibility and growth. It's as if you two share a similar path and were meant to know each other.
Aww. That's beautiful.
Do you think that means one more person will listen to this podcast? Because that would be gross.
You know what? At our advanced age, that gives me hope that growth is still possible. Who knows? Maybe this thing's going to take off.
Yeah, I think so. If a guy like... Have you ever seen Howard Stern?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, if he can do it...
Yeah. I wouldn't say that he's more handsome than either of us.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say he's less handsome.
How long has he been doing podcast?
I don't know.
Not very long.
2 weeks?
Yeah. So...
So you're telling me there's a chance...
Yeah, I think so. So happy birthday also, just before we go to the Slate News Quiz.
Yeah.
You want to announce the special birthday?
I do, yeah. So, you know, longtime fans of the show are going to remember the occasional...
2 weeks ago.
The occasional third mic, Boogie Knight.
Yeah.
It's his birthday today. So a big shout out and happy birthday to Boogie.
Don't you wish we could afford to get him as the regular third mic?
I really do.
I don't want to denigrate us, but I do think having him on the show made it much better.
You know what? We could call it Boogie Nights Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that a lot. So, yeah, happy birthday, Boogie. Also, Johnny Blocker, birthday today.
Really?
Yeah, April 3rd's a big day for birthdays. So, you know, friend of the show, Velvy Blocker.
How old of a man
child.
is Johnny?
I think this is 21 for Johnny.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Yeah, and he is, of course, living out in California currently with a friend of the show and sometimes Gunther Cunningham impersonator, Pat Kenning. Yeah. And Velvy's out there with Johnny and Pat right now.
As we speak.
Yeah.
Huh?
So
that's exciting.
Them. So, yeah, April 3rd. What a day for great men to be born, huh?
I think so. Yeah. You know, I asked Velvy if he could send us some music.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we could play it and people would enjoy it.
Yeah.
He sent it to me on Instagram.
What
do
kind
you
of
kids a- know how to do- move that to this format?
Yeah, I have no idea how that works.
If you are like a, if you know code, if you, all this stuff, you know how to do this stuff.
If you know code.
Do you know any nerds who could freelance this project?
I probably do. I could find a nerd to take
care of. Oh, Monica.
Those.
She's a nerd.
Oh, she's a total
she
nerd.
She could do it. So that's good. So we're gonna be hearing, if I can ever figure it out, we'll be hearing some music from Velvy Blocker.
Oh, that's exciting.
But in the meantime.
Yeah. Oh, Slate News Quiz.
Slate News Quiz.
Well, I got to pull up the
Here's rhyme. How this works, folks. We ask ourselves questions. Mm-hmm. From the Slate News Quiz. That's so stupid.
Yes.
And then we answer ourselves our own questions.
Yeah.
And then it kind of gives us opportunity to report on what the news is. And then also, you know, perhaps you'll get a little opinion about what's going on, okay? So, which Republican House member described some of his fellow Republicans as sexual deviants and cocaine users on a podcast?
Yeah, Madison Cawthorn.
Yeah, did you ever hear that? I don't really understand what is going on with that.
I didn't hear the blurb. What I read about it was he said on a podcast that he's been asked to participate in orgies and he's seen politicians do key bumps.
Okay. So, but he specifically said the Republicans, right?
I don't know if he specifically said the Republicans, but they're the ones that are taking umbrage at this.
Okay. Because they're out having sex orgies with cocaine.
Yeah.
But the Democrats are over eating babies and that type of stuff. So they're not into that type of thing.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah. They've got their own diversions. So I would actually like to listen to it to hear, because it sounds like they're attacking him like he's Al Franken.
Oh, wow.
You know.
Well, will you report back? Because I do not want to hear it.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
It'll
yeah.
be too much.
Yeah.
It'll be. Now, it's on a, what's it called? Podcast.
I don't get it. Oh, before we move on and the timer starts, I do want to ask you.
Yeah.
I think this is the appropriate time.
It sure is.
So you said you were going to focus on CBS News for this past week. I'm curious if you did
Great
that
question.
And if it's helping you. Here
Great question. I knew the answer to this one, but I decided to go with News Nation in the morning.
Hmm. Okay.
So it's WGN has become News Nation. It's right down the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And it is, I watched it for 4 days and then I went back to CNN in the morning. That's when I watch my news on TV.
Okay.
And It's more like a local news,
mm-hmm.
Which I hate more than anything else because they say these little things and they're insincere and there's nothing to it. But when they interviewed a Republican about the President Biden released some oil from the National Reserves,
mm-hmm.
Well, this guy, it's not good enough.
Well,
it's not going to do anything. The only thing that will come back is the pipeline once the pipeline is in,
of course,
you know.
Yeah.
And you know, and there may be truth with they don't have enough permits to drill here in the country. And then he says things like that we were energy independent in 2020. Do you know why we were?
No,
because nobody was doing anything. We're all locked down.
That's a good point.
And then we told the oil companies to shut her down, and they did.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're gouging us through every excuse they have. Oh, COVID's over. Oh, now it's going to be summer. Oh, now there's a war in Russia. They're gouging us all the way through.
Yeah.
But what Republicans continually love to do is blame somebody else who's not on their side for things. For example, it takes me back to tort reform. When all these doctors are mad at lawyers for suing them, but they're not mad at the insurance companies for gouging them and using the lawsuits as an example.
Yeah.
Intellectually, if they want to come in and say, I'm mad at everybody, okay, I get that. But instead, they're okay with these big companies making all kinds of money and doing everything. So everyone who's complaining about oil prices, no one's mad at the oil companies.
Which is so dumb. Yeah.
They're completely gouging us. So News Nation, they didn't push back on any of it.
Oh, wow.
And they didn't do what I think would be, if they're not going to push back, give the other side. And so I tapped out.
Well, hey, you tried.
I tapped out.
You gave it 4 days.
Yeah.
That says something.
Does it?
I don't know.
So anyway, I'm in my bubble, and there I am. Okay?
Okay. Fair enough.
So there you go. Next question. Thanks for asking.
Yeah.
Portions of Interstate 81 were shut down in which state after a fiery collision involved 80 vehicles during a snow squall?
Yeah. That was Pennsylvania.
Oh, no.
Did you see footage of that?
I think I did. It was like, I saw a wreck.
Yeah.
Almost killed somebody.
It was terrifying.
6 people were killed.
Yeah.
Wow, that's too bad.
Yeah. Yeah. Tragic. And I'm done with snow for the year.
No doubt.
Yeah. I'm sure those people are too. God, grief.
I would think they would be those people that were in accidents in the snow more than you. Now, here's the problem I have, Chris. This is a real problem. I'm right in the middle of the news thing. I'm going to say it.
Yeah.
Yesterday, it was nice. Mm-hmm. I got outside and cleaned up my backyard.
Oh, good for you.
Can't fall for it.
See?
Can't fall for it. It's time for spring. Get out.
Yeah.
Get everything going. Get the pool rolling. I can't fall for it.
You can't do it. There's the weather as Lucy holding the football. And, yes. And here you come with your big, dumb, round head to kick it. And
right.
Whoop.
It's right.
Pulled away at the last second.
And then
second.
I wake up with the head. The sinuses.
Yeah.
Because it's under, 30 degrees.
Oh, yeah.
And, yeah.
So you can probably hear it in my voice. I got the sinusy, I don't know if it's allergies or because of the temperature changes, but yeah.
And my wife grilled food last night outside.
Yum.
It's like, okay, nope, not falling for it.
Yeah. I'm sure the food was delicious.
May 1st? Okay.
Okay.
I'll get excited by it, but not yet.
May Day.
Okay. We'll see you then, folks. Question 3. Which House member resigned from office after being convicted of lying to the feds about a legal campaign donation of $30,000 from a Nigerian billionaire?
I don't know this one. I think it's that Fortenberry, but I'm not sure.
You were right.
Yay!
The Nebraska Republicans' resignation letter of the House opened with a poem, "Do It Anyway." Yeah.
All right.
So did he get an illegal campaign donation from a Nigerian billionaire? Because that sounds like a thing that I've been offered many times.
It does sound like the old email hack.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just give me $30,000 and yeah.
That's a good deal.
Yeah, I have no idea. I don't know. I mean, I really did guess. I've seen it in the news, but I was too busy looking at the slap. So stupid.
Yeah, so stupid.
Yeah.
What was your craziest reaction that you saw about the slap?
That I saw,
mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's craziest. The one I liked the best, and it was shortly after it happened, somebody tweeted, "God damn it, Will, this is the exact bullshit that got you sent to California in the first place."
I saw one that said, "Will Smith is now moving with his aunt and auntie and uncle to Bel Air," which is funny.
All that stuff's good.
So, News Nation, they report that the Academy asked Will Smith to leave.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I say to the missus, no, they didn't. That's a complete lie. They didn't. The Academy, whoever the hell they are.
Yeah.
If it was like the Umbrella Academy, I'd be like, okay, this is cool. or even the people that sell me sports equipment.
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
But I don't know what this Academy is.
Yeah. Is it people? I don't know. Yeah.
And then I go, that's a complete lie. She's like, they reported it. It's not a lie. I go, it's a lie. Hours later, mm-hmm. it was a lie, and I mm-hmm. sent it to her. She goes, why, you know some stuff. I said, well, that's why people listen to Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Yeah.
And then you have that Will Smith resigned from the Academy.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean.
Yeah, I read an article. I'm like, I don't know what that means.
Does he not get his yearly magazine now? I mean, what?
The only thing it means is he can't vote. Like, I guess as a member, you get to vote on Oscar stuff.
Yeah.
He can still come to the events. He can still get nominated. He can still win awards.
Okay, here's Academy.
Yeah.
Whoever you are. Let's take the awards and let's not make it a television show anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Make it a chance for peers to recognize each other and mm-hmm. then televise it. See the difference?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I do.
Now, that switch, the Super Bowl has also become a television show where they play football.
Right.
As opposed to a football game they televise.
Mm-hmm.
I'm okay with it. But this has got to, it's got to change. It's got to, you know.
Yeah.
And then the cuter than cute. Oh, we have three women who are now. And Amy Schumer, she comes out and goes, they hired three women because it's cheaper than hiring one man.
I saw that.
I mean, I love that.
Yeah.
And then her other funny joke, which is true, and they all laugh and won't do anything about it. What a great year for women where we get a picture about the brave Williams sisters' dad. Did you hear that joke?
I heard that one too.
Yes. It's like, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, just enough.
Yeah.
Enough. Thank you, Gilly. Thank you. Let's go to the next question.
Chris. Okay,
enough
yeah.
Enough of me meandering around. Hey, okay?
By the way, we're doing good on this so far.
Okay, question four. Russian Ukrainian delegations have been holding peace talks in which city?
I do not know the answer to this.
The choices we have is Athens, Rome, Budapest, Istanbul.
I'm going to think Budapest, but I don't
I'm
know
gonna
if
go
that's
with that
right.
Too. Oh,
well. Oh. What? Wait, I'll let you do the sound. Oh, fuck.
Istanbul.
Yeah.
Turkish president, among the leaders. I mean, talk about a symbol of democracy. Turkey. Great. Now, they also say the news tells us that Russia has said they're doing not really a retreat, but a pause.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And people are like, oh, wow. Every diplomat or anyone that knows anything is going, yeah, they're just setting up to screw them worse.
Yeah, how can you believe anything, you know?
Yeah.
You know what? We're just going to take a pause.
Yeah. Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, these scumbags are just, they're killing hospitals and schools and you know,
barbaric.
Now, the U.S. has done that.
Mm-hmm.
And I would imagine they've even targeted sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
But usually the U.S. it's like, oh, my God, we killed. You can't kill a hospital. We bombed a hospital by mistake and it's a deal.
Yeah.
And then the powers that be shuffle it under the carpet and move on. But you know what I mean? At least there's we shouldn't be doing that. I think we'll lie about it.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, at least we sort of acknowledge and do the, I'm a little stinker.
Yeah.
And
just like, you know,
but it's just the bald faced lying.
Yeah. When you were a kid, yeah, I studied for the test. You know, you didn't.
Yeah.
But you told them. And now they're like, no, I didn't study. Come on.
Yeah.
No one has enough respect for each other nowadays. They don't lie.
To lie.
Each other.
Yeah.
We got one more question. We got big news here. We have the texter who's joining us.
Oh, shit. I mean, heck.
So we're glad that the texter is here with us. The U.S. Supreme Court agreed to hear a challenge to California law that seeks to address cruelty to which animals?
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
I'm going to say horses because there's been a lot of at the racetracks out there.
That makes sense.
Another podcaster, fellow podcaster, mm-hmm. tip of the hat to Phil Henry. He talks about this quite a bit.
Oh, okay.
And let's see if it's horses. Oh, you screwed us again, Phil Henry. God. You screwed us again. It's pigs. Pigs.
Folks, we didn't do good. We got 3 out of 5 right.
Proposition 12 requires the pork sold in the state come from breeding pigs' house and spaces that allow them to move around freely. Yeah, we have a problem in Missouri with these CAFOs.
What's a CAFO?
It's a contained animal feeding operation. I think that's right. And they're all just put together, and it's
just like you're in a teeny stall where you can't move. And yeah, all you and do it, is eat.
Well, and the pollution is worse than anything.
Yeah,
and they always want to put them out in rural Missouri.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, rural Missouri, who typically will vote Republican. All of a sudden this happens, and they're mad about it, and. Then in the legislature, at least, they turn to the Democrats to try to stop it. And I'm like, that's really funny. So, Chris.
Yeah.
We got 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
For the news quiz. I guess the truth is that we did do better than not better. What? What am I trying to say? We had a winning percentage?
Yeah, we got more. If we were baseball players and we got on base, 3 times out of 5 at-bats, we'd be thrilled.
Mm-hmm. Don't you think that something was off?
Yeah.
And who would you blame for not being...
Well, I blame Will Smith.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, I blame the texter for not being
on. Yeah.
With his hilarious comments like he's already put down.
Oh, boy.
Rural Missouri is full of gays.
See, I don't think we throw that around like that
anymore.
But,
so what?
Yeah.
Big deal if it is.
Yeah.
So, love to know the...
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
I don't know if we want to talk about this for past week or next week, but there is a lot of excitement in this town for a little team called the Kansas Jayhawks.
Jayhawks. Rock Chalk.
Now, have you been following them?
I watched part of the game yesterday.
Okay.
So I did that. I'm pulling for them. I want to see the local boys win.
It was making me mad yesterday when they kept saying, oh, KU versus Nova. That just pisses me off that they're calling Villanova Nova for short.
Is it because you did not care for Nova, the superhero in the Marvel Universe?
That's correct. Okay. A complete ripoff of Green Lantern.
Yeah.
And, No.
But Nova had wristbands. Green Lantern had a ring.
Yeah, but he was an interplanetary police force, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. Okay. Yeah. And he could make things with his wristbands.
Yes, yeah. So it's different.
Yeah.
But anyway, I am excited for all my friends who love the Jayhawks and the excitement of the town.
Mm-hmm.
But I hate college basketball. I just hate very much.
Wow.
Yeah. It's ridiculous. It's crazy. It's indentured slaves too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I know things are supposedly going to get better, but yeah. I don't know if it is.
It's trending in a different direction where those kids can get compensated because the revenue they bring into those schools.
Yeah.
Egads, man.
So they're barely making it, but they're going to bring a national championship. So some guy in, I don't know, Prairie Village, who has some big construction job, bunch mm-hmm. of kids and stuff, rich wife, nurse, can just sit around and be happy about it.
Physical therapist, I believe.
Yeah.
And I believe a doctor of physical therapy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So they can just sit around and act like they're all that in a bag of chips. So Blue's joined
the podcast over here. I'll tell you what, she makes intense eye contact with me. It's intriguing and enthralling and a little unsettling.
I feel uncomfortable you talking about my
dog.
Could
we have a break?
Don't make fun of Blue again.
I'm not making fun of Blue. We need to go have a moment.
Okay, we're gonna have a Blue moment.
Oh wait, Gilly's doing something to Blue down. Good God, what am I in over here? It's like Caligula.
With more past week next week with Chris and Paul. I'll make fun of my dogs.
looking at the past 7 days so you don't have to. You could join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060.
We've been told that perfect mornings exist for the lucky few. That morning people own the waking hours. But the truth is, mornings belong to all of us. Your mornings are what you make of them. All it takes is saying yes. Starbucks Morning Yes.
Look for Starbucks coffee in a grocery store near you, then sit back and enjoy the exceptional taste of Starbucks at home.
Hi, this is Chickless Goose from Counterclockwise KC. Listen to our program each and every Saturday and Sunday at 7 p.m. right here on KCTK Radio. Personality driven radio.
Hi guys, it's your old friend Paul from KCTK Radio, reminding you again to download the KCTK Radio app. You're listening and you're going, I don't need the app, but you do need the app. Here's why. It's free, okay? You already got Candy Crush, all kinds of jackleg apps on your phone.
It's free. It's free.
Yeah,
it's
just free. Get it for free. And then if you ever want to participate live sometime, you can put the notification on there. Also, you always can get the podcast on there as soon as they come out. So it's a fun thing to do. I'm asking you. I'm pleading with you. Please. You're going to have fun. I've noticed something about you. You need to relax a little bit. You know, you need to kind of chill out.
Get away from TikTok.
Yeah, get away from TikTok for a little bit and listen to the KCTK Radio app. It's free. It will get into your brain, and it will never leave you. So join us on the KCTK Radio app and have fun for once in your life. Do it the KCTK podcast way.
This is our time when we talk about our sponsors. I'm excited to tell you about our sponsor, KCTK Radio.
What?
Some exciting new changes that are coming up.
Oh, God. I want to hear this.
First, the week review returns.
It's back?
Yes. It's going to be back Thursday.
Oh, about time.
It's moved from a weekly show to a monthly show.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Because I'm busy.
Yeah, you got stuff to do.
But it's still called the week review.
Uh-huh.
Okay. You understand why.
Yeah, because it's spelled W-E-A-K.
Yes.
Because the quality of the review just isn't there, folks.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. And we lost Tracy's Tips and Dips. I think they're going on Fox Business News channel.
I am so... And it's not just me. A lot of people are going to be sorry to hear that.
Well, we wish Tracy the best.
Love Tracy.
And we knew a shooting star would never stay that long with us.
Well, you know, when you burn twice as hot, you only burn half as long.
Wow, that's nice.
Yeah.
But we have, I've been getting a lot of solicitations, and you can give me some consultation from Christian programs.
Really?
Music, talk programs, and they want to be on KCTK, and I think we'll load it up. So you can get your Sunday morning inspiration.
Wow.
And feel good about yourself, feel good about your spirituality, and then turn on our program, and we'll bring you back to earth.
So, interesting. You've had Christian programs reach out to you.
I already have two of them that we play every Sunday morning.
Wow.
And now we have two more that reached out, and they want to be also on the network.
Dude, you could be like the next Jim Baker.
You think so?
Yeah.
Did you see Jessica Chastain talk about...
No, I didn't see it.
She said that Tammy Faye was such a great spirit. She was a freaking criminal, man. Have you seen the movie?
I saw the movie, yeah.
Did they make her look good or bad?
They made her look like a victim. A little bit. Yeah.
I heard that she lived in a mansion and then she was nice to one guy who had AIDS. And so she's a hero.
Well, they did sort of portray that. You know, who knows? But they portrayed her as among all of these, like, vile people that actually was nice.
Oh, okay.
But got caught up in... Because she did. She was concerned about people with AIDS. And everybody in her circle was like, "What? You know, why are you doing that? Ugh, they're terrible
people." She died,
people.
Right?
She did, yeah.
Yeah. Well, so, her husband has a great lawyer. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Jay Nixon's his lawyer. Let's come back to the show.
Oh, yeah.
So, anyway, check out KCTK. A lot of new exciting things happening. And you should listen. You should listen all the time. Because your phone, as the guy said in the ad here.
Oh, that guy.
Listen, I got a group of investors who love the program.
Yeah.
How can we get this to more people, they say. And they want to buy an AM radio station.
Oh.
That's exciting, right? Yeah. You know, AM, you know, Rush Limbaugh started on AM. Gary Owens started on AM.
Did he?
He sure did.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Well, yeah, where else would he have started, I guess?
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. But
Marconi started on AM.
Right. Do you have an AM radio anywhere?
I think there's one in my car.
Okay. You think?
I think. I don't know. I can neither confirm nor deny that.
Okay. So you don't know?
No.
Do you have an app for a smartphone?
I do. Yeah.
Where is it? In your car, away, where you have to check it? Where is it?
It's always with me right here on my smartphone device.
Right. KCTK Radio is always with you, unlike AM radio.
Yeah.
Hey, but enough of that. We haven't talked enough about this so far. Show business.
Yeah.
And you're going to love the stories we have.
Oh, yeah. I haven't even looked, to be honest with you.
Let's talk about some showbiz news.
Okay. Hey, here we go, folks. Chris Rock didn't want Will Smith removed after the award show slap. Like many people who watched the encounter that ended with Will Smith slapping Chris Rock on stage Sunday at the Academy Awards ceremony, Oscar's lead producer Will Packer thought it was a planned bit. But as Smith, angered by a joke Rock told about Smith's wife, Jada Pinkett Smith, yelled obscenities from the audience before he walked on stage to confront Rock, Packer realized it was real.
Doesn't Will Packer sound like Chris Norton?
Sounds like a joke name, yeah. Right? Chris Norton.
Chris Norton name.
Yeah.
And he's the lead producer, but he thought it was a bit?
I don't know. Maybe.
Would he not know it was a bit?
You would think, but maybe they don't screen what all the presenters are going. I don't know. But is weird to me.
Did you think it was a bit?
I did not think it was a bit.
Well, by the time you saw it, though, you knew it wasn't, right?
Well, that's true. Yeah. But when I saw it on Twitter first, and people were like, no, that's staged. No, it's not. I swear to you, it's staged.
I thought it was staged when I first saw it.
And I'm like, this doesn't feel staged.
Yeah.
It feels real and very uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad that he didn't. This is bullshit, too. I mean, they weren't ever going to remove him, and now they're just saying Chris Rock didn't. Yeah. It's not true. It's not true. Speaking of other things not true, Wanda Sykes weighs in on the Oscar slap.
Oh, okay.
Comedian Wanda Sykes has opened up about the slap heard around the world on Ellen DeGeneres' daytime talk show. Sykes, one-third of the trio who hosted the Oscars on Sunday, said while she didn't witness Will Smith slapping presenter Chris Rock because she was changing outfits. She did see Smith's profane verbal exchange with Rock in the moments after. I just felt so awful to my friend Chris, and it was sickening, she told DeGeneres, according to a preview clip. I felt ill, and I'm a little traumatized by it. Okay, I wanted to say this about the whole thing.
Yeah?
Everybody you talk to. If I was there, I would have done this. If I was Chris Rock, I would... You know what you would have done? The exact same thing these people did. Like, look around, like, what the hell is going on?
Yeah. I was in shock at home. I can't imagine what it would have been like to be there.
Yeah. But do you think Will would have tried to slap if it was one of the three female people?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Yeah.
What if it was The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, or Jason Mimosa?
First of all, Jason Mimosa sounds delicious right
doesn't
now.
It though?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
Mm-hmm. So... well, hey, we haven't talked about it enough, but
yeah, what's next on the thing?
Let's hear what Amy Schumer has to say as she weighs in on the Oscars slap.
Okay, great.
Schumer took to Instagram to share her thoughts, stating she was feeling triggered and traumatized.
I love my friend at Chris Rock and believe he handled it like a pro, she wrote. Stayed up there and gave an Oscar to his friend at Questlove, and the whole thing was so disturbing. I'm still in shock and stunned and sad. I'm proud of myself and my co-hosts, but yeah, waiting for this sickening feeling to go away from what we all witnessed.
Yeah. She did nothing either. I mean, her and Wanda didn't do anything. I guess the only thing, Amy came back and said, hey, I was backstage. What happened?
Yeah.
That was kind of funny.
Yeah.
Now, do you hear that the people who did the documentary that Questlove won are mad at Chris Rock?
No.
When he announced it, he said the winner is Questlove and three white guys.
I see. I didn't even hear the announcement afterwards.
I think he was just so much in shock. He just give the guy a break.
Oh, boy.
So there you go. Yeah. Now, good news. We have another big award show coming up.
Oh, thank God.
Tonight. How to watch the 2022 Grammys. The Grammys are happening this Sunday, which is tonight.
Yeah,
a sure little later than usual, but happening nonetheless. Explanation point. Pushed from June due to surge in COVID-19 cases, the 64th Grammy are set in Las Vegas this year. Expected performance from Gen Z stars and nominees Lil Nas X, Olivia Rodrigo, and perennial winner, she's already a perennial winner, Billie Eilish. She's been around for like in the consciousness for 3 years.
Yes.
As well as appearances by Silk Sonic, that's Bruno Mars, and Anderson .Paak's group.
Love them.
John Legend. Of course John Legend's going to be there.
Yes.
He has to. There's a camera. And Carrie Underwood. And here's how you watch the biggest night in music. The Grammys, April 3rd, 8 p.m. Eastern Time on CBS. Will you be watching this?
No.
Yeah, I won't either.
No, I don't care.
This is even stupider than the Oscars.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. Yes, it is. It's stupider than the Oscars. There's so many people that win Grammys that I don't know who they are at all.
Right.
Even more so than the Oscars. And it seems like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but the Grammy doesn't have the prestige of an Oscar.
I heard people talk this week that they didn't like Timothy Charlemagne.
Sure, yeah, that's exactly
because he didn't wear a shirt to the Oscars, and the Oscars is the thing that you're supposed to get all glammed up and formal for.
Yeah,
this isn't the Teen's Choice Awards from Nick at Night or whatever it is.
I saw.
Did you care about that?
I didn't care. I saw. I think it was Kimmel do some joke about poor Timothy Charlemagne.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Thought he was going to be the talk of the Oscars for not wearing a shirt.
Yeah.
And then
what a dork.
Yes.
He's not all built or anything either.
Yeah.
Yes. You want to see him without a shirt more than me. I get that. But he's not like Mr. Beefcake.
No, he's just skinny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, I got to tell you this, too. I don't like Trevor Noah.
Oh, you don't?
I don't.
Wow. How come?
I think he's too glib.
Hmm.
And I've been trying to watch The Daily Show sometimes. And they don't have a studio audience yet until next week.
Uh-huh.
And he starts off with, so what did you think of this? And he's like talking to a guy on that you don't see.
Do you think there's a real guy there?
Well, I think there's a real guy there, like a producer. But they make it act like it's so off the cuff. And just, this is just off the cuff. It said he's so funny. And it's all written.
Oh, gotcha.
It's just stupid.
See, I don't, my wife loves him, but she doesn't watch The Daily Show. She watches little clips and then will share them with me. And
she's a millennial too, right? I mean, she's quite a bit younger than you.
Yeah, I don't know that she's actually a millennial, but she is. She's definitely young at heart.
Oh, okay. Back to you, Chris.
Hey, thanks, Paul. On the lighter side, Bruce Willis stepping away from acting because of health condition. This one was actually very sad to me.
Mm-hmm.
Bruce Willis is suffering from a medical condition that's affecting his cognitive abilities and will be taking a break from acting, his family shared Wednesday. In a post on his daughter Rumor's verified Instagram account, the caption on a photo of the diehard actor read, "To Bruce's amazing supporters, as a family, we wanted to share that our beloved Bruce has been experiencing some health issues and has recently been diagnosed with aphasia, which is impacting his cognitive abilities." I did a little research on aphasia after hearing this, and I mean a very little, because I thought, oh, God, is it a stroke? Is that what he had? But it's not. And with the right kind of therapy, people can recover from this, but it messes up your language.
What's the, is it a genetic thing? Is it a...
I don't know. Like, I mean, I did just a...
Okay.
And by research, I mean, I did a quick Google while I was sitting on the can.
Right.
So, but...
Just like the anti-vaxxers.
Yes. So I guess there may be hope that, who knows if he could return to acting, but just maybe be able to function and...
Okay, my first thing I want to say about this is I believe he left acting after Pulp Fiction, okay? But let's just move on with that. You know, he was nominated for like a whole bunch of Razzie Awards for Bet because he's been making a whole bunch of really bad movies, even direct-to-streaming movies.
Yes.
And people are like, what's going on? One of the biggest movie stars we've ever had is doing this. He must have seen this coming. He must have been like, I'm going to lose my ability to earn. I got to get a lot of stuff under my belt, some paychecks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Poor guy,
yeah. So there you go. And finally, back to me, Chris.
Yo, yeah, Paul.
And I'm sorry that this is a thing, but I'm going to read it.
Okay.
Sesame Workshop debuts a new character uses a wheelchair. Amir, the latest Muppet character from the team at Sesame Workshop, will soon make her debut on the new season of some version of Sesame Street that airs in the Middle East. A born leader, Amir is 8 years old and loves science and basketball. When she's not dreaming up experience or shooting hoops, she loves cracking jokes and making her friends laugh. So I guess she's a Muppet that's in a wheelchair.
Oh, okay.
Is that a thing? I mean, can we just have a Muppet come on with a wheelchair and just go, oh, okay.
But what, I mean, isn't that what's happening? Or you mean the announcement?
The announcement.
Oh,
gotcha. And why don't they do it on Sesame Street? Why do they have to do it
on
a la Simpson?
Yes. On Al Jazeera, Sesame Street.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm fine with having a Muppet in a wheelchair. I think representation's super important.
I don't know. Some of these things I get from pop culture, they're like patting themselves on the back too much.
Well, I think that's the problem.
And like, it's like, just
give me an award and kudos for doing it instead of
do it.
Oh, okay. That's nice. They're representing,
yeah,
including lots of people in their representation.
That's. Let's get to some serious stuff though, because let's check in with the texter.
Oh, that's a good idea.
He's looking our way. He was trying to get our attention.
Yeah.
He went to coffee with his family, so it was a little late, and to a Mexican Price Chopper to get apples for Croatian apple strudel.
Listen to all the international intrigue.
Now
in
listen
that
to that. That's America right there.
Yeah.
This American guy.
Yeah.
Goes to a Mexican Price Chopper to get apples.
Wow.
Where are those apples from, you think?
Well, let's say that they're Canadian
apples.
Yeah,
Canadian apples to make Croatian apple strudel. Isn't strudel kind of German?
Yeah. That one text is like an entire Benetton ad.
Yes.
That's amazing.
Yeah. He's really on top of stuff. And then he went with the Drush. He has, I don't know what that next thing's for or why.
Know.
It's unnecessary.
Yeah.
Now, I have a friend that goes by the name of Velvet who says that the texter has a lot of bitterness inside of him. And I think he believes that person he referred to there is a Villanova fan. Mm. I think that's where he was.
Sorry, Nova fan, Paul.
Oh, sorry. You get solicitations because you're a hooker.
That's fair.
Who gets, did I?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
fair enough. No, I'm not. I'm not a hooker. I don't get paid. Pirates wore eye patches to have one eye adjusted to top deck and the other adjusted to darkness when going below deck.
You know what? That actually makes sense.
Rush was a quality human that did no wrong to anyone in the mental health of our country.
Is he
talking about
that.
Rush Limbaugh?
Yeah.
Who started all the fake news stuff? And destroyed
our country.
I believe
so. Or it could be the power trio Rush. I'm not sure what he's talking about.
I think they
about.
Both started the end of democracy.
Yes.
Another thing. Okay. Dogs line up in Earth's electromagnetic field when they poop. They typically prefer a north-south axis.
So
I agree with that.
I've is that why before. They spin around and around and around? They're trying to get their bearings?
Also, have you noticed when a dog's going, they're looking at you?
Yeah.
You know why?
Why?
They love you. No, because they want you to have their back when they're vulnerable.
Oh, okay.
And they're vulnerable when they're shitting.
Yeah.
Okay.
Questlove is not his given name. I don't know if that's true or not.
Yeah.
Dear, the future is now and the past is the past. Do you think a sad song is less effective with an upbeat tempo?
I do.
Now, why is that? Why is he bringing that up?
I don't know.
I said this to my wife at the Todd Rundgren thing.
Really?
So there's a song, and I can't remember. It's a Beatles song.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the most upbeat song, and the lyrics are so sad. So sad. And I don't know what it is, but I love music like that.
Yeah.
I don't even want to look it up now.
Build Me Up Buttercup is another one of those songs. If you go and look at the lyrics, like the guy's just getting completely mistreated.
You won't see me.
Yeah.
La, 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 la. And he's just heartbroken lyrics. And I find myself really liking that because I guess I'm a phony. That outside I'm trying to be positive, inside I'm dying.
Oh, wow. I think you're really on to something.
Yeah, that just described me, didn't it?
Wow.
And who brought it out of me? The texter.
God love him.
Yeah. Do you guys know when the watch party for the the Lakewood local is for Kentucky? Yes.
Yep, sure.
They're going to do it the Saturday they run the Kentucky Derby, which is going to be in May. So
that seems
mark
appropriate.
That down.
Yeah.
Mark that date down. No shirts, no shoes, no service. That's fair. You don't like Trevor because you're a racist. No, I just don't. I think he's too glib.
Okay.
And too, I don't know.
Yeah.
Just.
You cannot like someone of a different race and not be racist.
Yeah. Let me try to be. I like him. I want the best for him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he's funny.
Hmm.
Now, in a way, that sounds nicer, but in a way, for a comedian, that's worse.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know? Okay, let's go back to the great stuff that Texter clearly.
Yeah, this is top-notch stuff here.
I don't know how we missed him before.
This guy's spitting gold.
Did you know that Bruce Willis was in the movie Pulp Fiction? He was.
Yeah.
Was he brought out at the Oscars? No.
No.
He was you could say he was like the star of it.
Yeah. Yep. Hey, and let me say one other thing. I did see the three hosts, the three ladies that were cheaper than one man.
Yeah.
They made a joke about LeBron's hair.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
He suffers from, like, he's so tall that the airplanes hurt his head.
Yeah. Yeah, they made a joke that something about the Space Jam folks should win best special effects for making LeBron look like he has a hairline.
That's a great joke.
He didn't go up and slap anybody. No. All right, I'm done.
Or his spouse.
Yeah.
Just to clarify from the texter, LeBron James plays basketball professionally.
That's good to know.
And he calls the Sesame Street simply the street.
Oh, I like
that. I always wondered, when I would talk to the texter, he's like, I'm from the street.
Yeah, you never knew that he meant Sesame Street.
Right. Hey, guys, we're all caught up.
Oh, thank God.
And we are set. We're ready to go for the next week.
Sure are.
And the way we get prepared is through headlines and predictions. It's news stories with a twist.
Folks, these are ripped from the headlines. These are actual news stories. But Paul and I each write our own hilarious punchlines that actually aren't news, but they give a funny spin on it.
I like it better when you do a Bill Grigsby ripped.
Can you do it? Ripped from the headlines. Thanks. At the Price Chopper. All right, here we go,
the Mexican Price Chopper.
Yes. Where you can get Croatian apples for your German strudel. Russian and Ukrainian officials announced a temporary ceasefire in the battered southern port city of Mariupol to let civilians out and humanitarian aid in. About 100,000 residents are believed to be trapped in the besieged city, which was home to 450,000 before Russia invaded Ukraine. Russian negotiators are suggesting that any residents still left in the city should belong primarily to Russia, but be allowed to visit Ukraine every other weekend and 2 weeks during the summer. Paul?
That one had to hurt as a divorced man with children.
It hurt a little bit.
Well, President Biden ordered the release of 1 million barrels of oil per day from the nation's Strategic Petroleum Reserve over 180 days to help bring down crude oil prices driven up by Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Oil prices fell slightly in anticipation of the announcement. Hummers and jumbo pickup owners are now safe to drive around each city wearing their red hats and yelling, "Let's go, Brandon." Chris?
It's funny. It's just not even a joke. Yeah. That's the problem. The Commerce Department reported that the Personal Consumption Expenditure Price Index, the Federal Reserve's preferred inflation gauge, rose 6.4% in February compared to a year earlier. It was the biggest increase in 40 years. The change reflected sharply higher prices for necessities, including food and gasoline. So-called core inflation, which leaves out volatile food and energy costs, increased by 5.4%. Mm-hmm. President Biden was quick to point out that if you also leave out core inflation, we're looking pretty, pretty good.
Yeah.
Paul?
Very good. Thanks. A federal judge in Florida ruled part of Florida's year-old election law is unconstitutional, saying that they were enacted to discriminate against black voters. Judge Mark Walker, I think you grew up with him, said the state can't enforce provisions limiting the use of ballot drop boxes, imposing strict rules on voter registration organizations, and prohibiting some kinds of assistance to people waiting in line to vote. Florida's Republican Governor Ron DeSantis signed the law last May as GOP legislators around the country were changing voter laws in response to the 2020 election. You know, the one where all the registered black voters showed up to vote against the Republicans. Chris?
Thanks, Paul. And this in just from the texter, Ron DeSantis is a dick.
Must be factual.
On the lighter side, folks, Disneyland in California has introduced peanut butter and jelly pasta. The dish, which is being called a dessert pasta, is now available as part of the Disney California Adventure Food and Wine Festival. Peanut butter and jelly mac consists of macaroni noodles coated in peanut butter sauce and finished off with a dollop of strawberry jelly, a sprinkle of brown sugar streusel, a layer of strawberry crackle, and two diabetic test strips. Paul?
Oh, the texter was yawning at that one. And finally, a Canadian company is attracting attention for its new policy where it pays candidates for a job interview. Nonprofit organization Food Share Toronto says that since March 1st, it has been paying job applicants $75 per interview conducted with the company. Food Share says it's recognizing the fact that people sometimes must take off their current job to go to the interview, their travel costs, plus child care expenses, and employers should be paying for that. In related news, podcast star The Droosh will be visiting Toronto over the next few months for some big opportunities.
Nice, 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 nice. Well done, sir. Well done.
Those were hilarious jokes.
They were really, really good.
But let's
go
to the real funny ones from the texter. Perhaps Ukraine and Russia is a violent and unnecessary conflict.
That is hilarious.
Who is the person stealing the things behind you? One of Gilly's very best friends came down and grabbed Gilly while you were reading.
Oh, okay, good.
She's a nice lady. Ron DeSantis is a dick.
Yep.
You said Food Share.
Damn it.
Which has to be a fat joke, right?
No.
Like, stop. I never would share food. Is that what it is?
I don't know. I mean, I've never seen you share food.
Right. But it could happen.
Yeah, I...
Chris?
Yeah.
Thanks for just going along with that. What's going on next week?
Oh, yeah, not a lot going on, actually. Got to get my damn taxes done. In fact, that's happening as soon as I get home, gathering all the crap.
Do you do the taxes your own damn self?
No. It's too complex because Jane has her own business, and so she's got to pay quarterly taxes, and there's a lot of deductions and figuring, and I don't know.
Do you have Velvy do them for you? He works at H&R Block, I think.
I don't have him, and I think it's been about a decade since he's worked there.
Really?
So, yeah.
Wow.
I am going to go into the offices for the first time at my new job this week.
Now, where is that located?
It is on the former Sprint campus.
Okay.
So it's like the same damn place I've worked forever.
The same building?
I think it's the building you were in.
Maybe I was never on the Sprint campus. So
never, ever, ever? No. Okay, I can't.
Fuck you.
It's on the extreme southern end of the campus, building 6300.
Okay.
So I'm going to go in, and I'm actually going to meet the new director of the contact center there, who just came from, wait for it, H&R Block.
Really?
Yep.
Who's that?
His name's Phil Zimmer.
Oh,
he worked with Velvy years ago.
Oh, and sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it doesn't sound like, now, have we decided about the zeros?
I have to confirm the zeros. I don't think there's anything going on, so I'm assuming we're going to be there, but I've not really talked to my wife about it.
Text her?
So be cool.
Zeros?
Taxes? Type?
Yes, zeros. Term. Yeah, that's a big thing for me. I'm going to go to the Zeros concert on them.
They're so much fun.
They're so much fun.
Yeah. And really, like 80s, 90s cover band stuff, but they're very good.
Yeah. And you're not going to drink. It's going to be knuckleheads. We've been there before. Last time we drank too much. We talked about that on the show.
Yeah.
Yep. But you're never going to drink that much again?
No.
Come on, I'm Chris.
I'm not.
What if it's a special occasion and you're taken care of? And
I don't know. It sort of ruined my next day. I'm done with that. Like last night, I drank more than I intended, but I'm fine today. It wasn't the ridiculous amount that I had at the Prince, fake Prince concert.
Yeah. Well, that's the only thing I have going on that's of note.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And very excited about, I can't get too excited, but I'm excited about the warmer weather.
Mm-hmm.
I'm ready to get things rolling. And I don't know. Did you see Saturday Night Live last night?
I did not. No.
So they did a skit called, Does Your Brain Work?
Oh, okay.
What's it called? Game show.
Sounds like. Okay. Yep.
See, that was a perfect example of what the joke is. But since COVID, nobody's brain works anymore.
It's kind of true.
But so I'm excited for the weather to get out, be outside, and feel like maybe COVID is over. And I don't want to get too optimistic, but I'm going to. When the weather is consistently warm.
Mm-hmm.
I know that has nothing to do with it, folks. But just help me, okay? Just help me with this.
Well, I think people get depressed. I mean, during the cold winter, we're done. We're ready for that vitamin D, you know? Get out in the sun and feel better.
You've kept it together because of froth.
Love the froth. Yeah. It's actually disc golf.
Huh.
Today would be probably maybe I'll go throw some plastic today. I don't know. You don't know. Maybe I will.
Go throw some plastic.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what we call it in the biz.
Let's hear what the texter says, and then just call the show if you don't mind. Oh, it's a phrase like on the oldie time game show.
Yeah.
Food share. Food share. Food share. Taxes are socialist enterprise. You know what?
Yeah.
I saw some body on Facebook who's a libertarian said that you don't really have to do taxes.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, there's God, that's good to know.
There's no law for it. Okay. So just don't do it.
Okay.
Granny's Place, that's where Chris works now. Mm-hmm. Henry Block. I saw Henry Block one time when I was working down there, and he's a very nice man.
Oh, nice.
Yes, the zeros, they fucking bring it.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to slip somebody a Mickey at the show.
Oh, wow.
And looks like he's going to play froth today. We'd be remiss if we didn't say, go Jayhawks.
Yes.
I have a question.
Sure.
For you, and perhaps even the texter will know. Why is it that they play the game, so they play the semifinal games on Saturday, but then they play the final on Monday? What's wrong with Sunday?
I think they need a day of rest in between. You don't want to play back-to-back.
Okay, why didn't they do Friday and Sunday? What's wrong with Sunday? I think that would be like a Super Bowl, almost a second Super Bowl.
I think it's that Monday primetime audience. I don't know that... I'm just making this up, but I don't know. People will, like, stay inside. Super Bowl's a destination. Sundays, people might want to get out, not watch
the college basketball.
I think they
final.
Should make it another Super Bowl and do it on a Sunday and have, you know, parties and
I don't know.
It in the afternoon and have a good time.
You know, and they do the national championship of NCAA football on same like a Monday night. Yeah. I don't know.
So, a lot of us have to work.
Oh, but then the texter brings up an excellent point that you can't play on the Sabbath.
Yeah, they care about that.
Yes. Right? Yeah.
You only can play God's game, which is, of course, professional football. And there and one of his sons plays it, and his name is Tom Brady. Did you see that Tom Brady got rid of the coach?
Yeah, I saw the coach was stepping down.
Well, no, they promoted him. So let's just stop the show already, Chris.
Okay, yeah, for God's sake.
Will you take it away?
Yep, I sure will, folks. Let me grab this paper that I read every week. Thanks for listening to Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul. Since you love the program, please rate and review the podcast on your favorite podcast distributor, and we would love to hear from you. You can contact us at 913-735-0060 or at the email address pastweeknextweek@gmail.com. Also join the Past Week, Next Week Facebook page. And make sure you listen to all the great programs on KCTK Radio. Yeah. Plus, support all of our sponsors, including KCTK Radio.
Nice.
On behalf of Paul, I'm Chris saying goodbye.
I want to send you, thanks, Chris. And on behalf of Chris, I want to say, send you some good vibrations. And, you know, we've talked a lot about a rapper turned actor this week. But we didn't talk about the greatest rapper of all time who turned actor. His name is Mark Wahlberg.
Really?
And when you watch this Good Vibrations by the Funky Bunch, you're going to see how great a rapper he was.
God, how old is this song now? Did he just have this song or did he have an album ever?
He probably had an album.
Okay. This girl's good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Behind. Oh, he's strong. He's tough. What a turd. If I was him, I'd make sure this never showed anywhere.
I mean, to me, you're right. He's got a lot of talent. For me, this is too much Marky Mark and not enough Funky Bunch.
Yeah.
They don't get the billing they deserve. I feel like so far, there's like four scenes and they just keep showing the same ones over and over again. Do you think Mama's Gonna Knock You Out inspired the boxing in this?
Yeah.
I think it did too.
I think the guy that was the New Kids on the Block manager saw the little brother and said, we can create something.
Yeah. Look at this kid.
It's amazing he still has a career.
And like a crazy successful career.
I eat at his restaurant every week.
I've never had one of his Wahlburgers. Are they good?
No, but we have breakfast.
Oh, okay.
Because it's also a Hy-V.
Do they have a breakfast Wahlburger?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, that's sad.
Anyway, the point of this is good vibrations. That's what we're sending you for the next week.
Yep. Spring is either here or right around the corner. We all want to watch Marky Mark make love and think about the good vibrations headed our way.
Do you think if it was Marky Mark instead of Will Smith who slapped Chris Rock, we'd all be okay with it because we would remember how cool this video is?
I'm not sure that's what the outcome would be.
But look how cool it is, though.
Oh, my God, they were dabbing, and this is like 40 years old.
Yeah, right.
I didn't know dabbing was just coming back around.
Isn't it cold? He never wears a shirt.
He doesn't have a shirt. Who is he? Timothy Charlemagne?
Yeah.
Is that the Funky Bunch behind him, or is that his crew?
Clearly.
Oh, God. He just did... He's doing the Cool J licking his lips thing.
Yeah.
He's a total LL Cool J ripoff. I never knew that before.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
I don't think it worked.
What's your favorite Marky Mark movie?
I still love Rockstar.
That was a good movie.
Yeah. And he was, you know, he's such a dork in this video. It's not sending the good vibrations I wanted. But The Departed,
Yeah.
He stole the whole movie.
Yeah.
He was so great in that movie.
He was great in The Departed. You know what? Maybe he's a better actor than I think.
Yeah.
Because that was a very serious role. I also
with some real heavyweights around him too.
Yeah, and he was definitely holding his own.
How do you think he played like a smart ass guy from Boston? How do you think he,
how did he pull that off?
Yeah.
But I also thought a very underrated movie, in my opinion, is The Other Guys. Him and Will Ferrell.
Oh my God, I forgot about that. It was
and
hilarious.
I thought he was hilarious in
it's
that.
Great.
Yeah.
He just loves Will Ferrell's wife.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So
right.
He can do the funny and he can do the serious. So
I would like this to be erased from my memory. That'd be good vibrations for me. And then I would be fond of him.
Yeah. Yeah. So he can act serious, he can act funny, but he can't rap for shit.
Has been a KCTK production, produced by Paul Lavoda. If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctkradio.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.